Hello everyone, and we welcome 2020 with great gusto, great fervor and great freshness in our lives. January, I have not done it separately because actually you need to ponder over and drill into your minds what I have spoken in the annual chart. And February onwards is where we start working with our positive energies towards the journal and also realizing what we want to do, how we want to do it, and why should we do it, so that we benefit all about our energies and we benefit all about ourselves in the following decade. But February, I start with a horoscope which actually gives you an overview that how do you need to initiate your work and why should you initiate it now so that the productive levels reach their peak by December. So starting with your February horoscope of 2020, the overview is first, Mercury enters Pisces on February 3rd, and during this period, our thoughts become clearer through dialogue with others. We can use the power of words to advise or make peace with the people from our lives. Mars enters Capricorn on February 16th, and all the zodiac signs will get stimulated and become willing to act. And the activities performed will bring profit, status, stability and power. On February 17th, Mercury starts its retrograde motion. So this period can bring a lot of inspiration, imagination and artistic sense, increase activity and the ability to implement the things that we feel and we are sure that we can sow the seeds of success. Capricornians, what are you all about? You use everything which is in the world to your benefit and the benefit of other people. So your word is I use. So this month is very much of a party, happy-go-lucky month, but the emphasis is shifting and you will become serious as the month ends. Your career progress begins to move forward again and you're likely to enjoy good success in this department. Now, in the meantime, you're building the psychological infrastructure for future progress. So the horoscope indicates a major shift in your personal desires. You wish to develop your mind and ability to communicate. A desire to get more serious in the coming years to work in achieving towards your goals. So a desire to get involved in a steady, disciplined health regime is also in effect. Finances will be unusually strong until the 20th, but after that, it's kind of a mixed picture. There is a short-term conflict between your financial interests and those of your partner or spouse. Compromise will happen, but only after a struggle. Expenses in the home could affect the bottom line. Love remains status quo. The spotlight this month is on your area of personal income and your values. Changes in that area continue to surface, but things seem to magically work out for you. Your intuition is very much on target. Follow your hunches. Disagreements and restrictions at your home base could create tensions that will have to be cleared up for the sake of harmony. Cooperation will be necessary as certain items seem to be held back, bringing a lack of understanding. Your career seems to have been taking off in the right direction, but uncertainty is bothering you in regards to money and a compensation matter. With your money house highlighted, you'll be happier than always. Always your favorite subject can hold especially true. So this empowers you to perform more of your magic. Create enough to sit back on and smile. It may be time to direct your energies towards more compassionate ways of dealing with your family. With your money house highlighted, you'll be happier than before. And money can be your favorite subject, and this does hold specially true for Capricornians, but at the same time, you need to know how you're going to use this money. Now, this only empowers you to perform more of your magic. So utilize the money, since the money is going to be there, in much more creative ways. Create enough to sit back on and then smile. It may be time to direct your energies towards more compassionate ways of dealing with your family. Much can be accomplished. Don't push yourself or others too hard now. Keep up with current trends in your profession and keep communications active with those you work with. Be sure to maintain a healthy relationship between personal and professional life. Study the history of spells and incantations well, especially those from ancient days and other countries that come rich with folklore to enhance your own imagination. The 6th and 7th are days you'll not forget very soon. These can be seen as your power play days. Use them to enhance your possibilities and encourage good reactions from others. February 8th is sure to present you with many opportunities to enhance your money options. With 5 luminaries in your money house, you are bound to have more than one opportunity. Your horizon reaches wide now and you should not settle for just any old thing. You want to reach back into time where your mind was set on a beautiful and fanciful deed that only you could devise. Satisfying your current goals, you take the initiative and encourage others to join in this wonderful new opportunity. Let others see you for the leadership qualities that you have and the leader you really are. This period brings a culmination to recent educational pursuit or travel plans. You may find yourself completing a long process of analyzing data and health information or diet. Attend a special lecture or seminar to better your choices of life plan. The publishing of special papers or analytical data takes place now. Your energy bears fruit and you are recognized for your past efforts on the fine projects that may deal with social issues or art. There will be a break from the past that allows you to deal with hidden demons that obstruct you. Cut loose from their stronghold and set sails for brighter days. Capricornians, you need to think carefully about new purchases and wait for your moment. You are canny when it comes to striking deals and you need all your business instincts. Competition heats up for the big prizes and profit and prestige is bound up with the outcome. Prepare for the gloves to come off. Pluto doesn't play fair, but don't be dragged down to this level. Better to play it very zen-like. So be spiritual and acceptance is the keyword. Having completely drilled it into your mind, what is the annual chart telling you all to do or how is it guiding you all to do? I am sure most of you all have started maintaining your journals. And of course, I am there to always guide you every month that these are the things that can happen with your energies. How to negate them or how to utilize your positive energies is also what I am actually endeavoring to guide you all. Now, having done all this, make sure what are your money days, your honey days, your best career days, or what are the days that can be stressful, or what are the days that can actually be enjoyable for you. I have written all these details or I manage to or I endeavor to bring out these dates to the best of my ability and they are all available at my website. Now, taking those dates into consideration, you can actually maintain your journals very, very well. And those of you who have made their natal charts can always reflect back on their natal charts and reiterate your passions and your dreams, which you are going to manifest in 2020. Or even, as they say, most of you may be having the Saturn returns. Most of you may be knowing that where are your north nodes and your south nodes, that is the Rahu and Ketu. You can actually be an architect of your own life and color the life in the manner that you want to. So don't forget to visit my website and know exactly which are the tools that you need to take to cultivate the soil of your life.